Between 1095 and 1291 AD, the Pope launched 7 bloodbaths called the Christian Crusades, torturing, beheading, and mass murdering hundreds of Muslims and Jews in the name of God. Between 1450 and 1700 AD, the Catholic Church followed up their terror with the Holy Inquisition. Based on rumors of practicing witchcraft, the Catholic Church hunted down, tortured, and burned alive millions of innocent women at the stake. The Pope's soldiers were called Knights Templar, and later evolved into today's secretive brotherhood known as the Freemasons. George Washington himself was a Freemason. Washington's monument in D.C. was financed by 250 Masonic lodges, including the Knights Templar Masonic Order. The shape of it is based off of an Egyptian obelisk. Why Egyptian? The Egyptians placed these in the center of large open places in the temples of the solar god Ra. So who else in the world has these in their city-states? You guessed it, the city-state of London and the Vatican. Just who is all these city-states worshiping or paying tribute to? Other occult churches that could be related to the Freemasons is the Mormon or Latter-day Saints Church. They present and package their church as a very Christian, family-loving church. But behind closed doors, they are also practicing odd ceremonies. Many Mormons do not even know these rituals exist, for the ones that have participated are sworn to secrecy. The church also appears to have Masonic symbols located on the outside of the Mormon temple itself. Some Mormons have claimed to see miracles of God by seeing spirits flying down halls or disappearing from crowds. These may be spirits, but they are not from God. These rituals come from the pagans of the ancient. And when you come knocking on Satan's door, he will answer. There is also the infamous society known as Skull and Bones. This secret society was founded at Yale University and is known to use the same satanic rituals and blood oaths that the Freemasons have used. They are a secret network of international pirates who identify with no nation, no national flag, and no established religion. In fact, George Bush Sr. and George W. Bush are members, as well as John Kerry, the latter two both admitting to it in interviews.
You were both in Skull and Bones, the secret society.
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go wild.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the web.
Number 322.
You both were members of Skull and Bones, a secret society at Yale. What does that tell us?
Not much, because it's a secret.
Is there a secret handshake? Is there a secret code?
I wish there were something secret I could manifest.
322, a secret number?
There are all kinds of secrets, Tim, but one thing is not a secret. I disagree with this president's direction that he's taking.
Are these really the people leading our country? The Illuminati. This is a secret society of Freemasons who plan to strategically take control of the world. Their emblem has been seen by all, for it is on the back of the $1 bill. The name Illuminati historically refers specifically to the Bavarian Illuminati, an Enlightenment-era secret society founded on May 1, 1776. Their plan? To allegedly control world affairs through present-day governments and corporations. Their emblem? A pyramid with an overseeing eye. This is taken from the ancient Egyptian religion, the eye of the sun god Horus, the pagan god of the Egyptians. They believed the sun was the eye of their god. He was the solar divinity of the world. At the base of the pyramid, you can see the year in which the secret society was founded. In the upper corner on the right, there is a cleverly hidden owl. The Bush family actually maintains a strong involvement in this. Each year in California, at Bohemian Grove, members of this all-male club, including politicians and corporate bankers, don red, black, and silver robes and conduct an occult satanic ritual wherein they worship a giant stone owl called Molech, sacrificing a human being in effigy to what they call the Great Owl of Bohemia. They use the El, for they see it as all-wise, that it can see in the dark whereas others cannot. Most, if not nearly all the presidents of the United States have known to be participants in the satanic celebration. Their rituals also have been known to include the killing of young children, the drinking of human blood, and the consuming of flesh and human organs. The toll on human suffering and the loss of innocent lives are non-issues for these individuals, who are aligned with very dark, malevolent, fourth-dimensional aliens, known better as demons.
Once more, the Sith will rule the galaxy. And we shall have peace.
The Council on Foreign Relations, or CFR, is a semi-secret organization. It was established in 1971, and the members are exclusively Americans and Canadians. Today, the CFR holds a tight control over the countries of the Western world, with help from sister organizations and its mother organization in Britain. The CFR is in its turn controlled by the Rockefellers and also works for a global government. There is also the event of what is called the Bilderberg Meeting, where all international leaders form together on private property with top-level security, and it's not even mentioned on the news. The Illuminati event to give the American people the belief and appearance that a real democratic election event is happening. The 2006 elections cost an astounding total of about $3 billion to run for all these Senate and congressional seats. If you don't have a few million dollars behind you, don't even bother being a candidate in an American election. And the people are misled to believe that anyone can become a senator or congressman? Yeah, right. All the Illuminati has to do was funnel these billions of dollars to the candidates of their choice and ballyhoo the candidate they wanted to win in their corporate-controlled media. The Illuminati have been keeping it all in the family by inbreeding with cousins over centuries, doing just what the Rothschilds did. Take a look at Bush's family tree and you'll see who else might be in on the secret. Even Barack Obama is related to six other US presidents. The Illuminati have their agenda, a long-term plan in place, and they will let nothing get in their way for them to achieve it. If a president, vice president, senator, or congressman has some change of heart and starts to do the right thing, the Illuminati will put up a lot of money to see to it that they are removed from office by any means possible. If you start to look for it, you'll start seeing the signs of the Illuminati everywhere. They stamp their symbols on everything, from the $1 bill to the logos on big corporations. They have it all over the media, probably laughing their heads off as they throw this garbage right in front of you and nobody seems to notice. They are behind nearly everything now, for it is necessary for their goal to be achieved.
Drive your ambulances. We guard you while you sleep.